What's going on, friends? Last week, we saw what a 107 Milwaukee 8 could do with just a bolt-in cam. I asked you guys if you wanted to see the 114. You said yes. So this week, we're going to take a look at what a 114 can do with just a bolt-in cam. And to be honest, the results were pretty surprising. The 107 M8 had pretty impressive results with just a bolt-in cam. But when you start bolting in these same cams into a Milwaukee 8114, the difference in cubic inches starts to become very noticeable, especially in the torque. You do gain a little bit in the horsepower, but not as much as the torque. And not to mention, a bolt-in cam is going to make your M8 sound like a Harley should. Now bear in mind, these cams can be used in a 107 or a 114, but taking a look at these in the 114s, these were the ones that really had the smoothest graphs that I really kind of thought you guys would like the best. But guys, stick around to the end of the video because the last cam on the list today is one that you would never believe it's a bolt-in with the amount of horsepower and torque this thing produces over stock. With nothing else but a Stage 1 kit, a good tune, and just bolting in one of these cams. Now looking at any bolt-in cam and looking at horsepower improvements, it really doesn't do us any good if we don't take a look at what the base horsepower is on a Milwaukee 8114. Now this is the same bike, but they did the dyno run in fourth gear and in fifth gear. Now top gear, we're going to go with the fifth gear run. We'll say 86.17 horsepower and 107.35 foot-pounds of torque. That's not bad at all. That's about 4 to 6 horsepower over what the stock 107's making, and roughly about 10 foot-pounds more torque than a stock 107. But this graph right here just goes to show you that it really makes a difference on who's operating the dyno with your motorcycle. You're getting two different horsepower numbers here because it was run two different ways on the same dyno on the same motorcycle. So once again, getting it tuned by somebody that's highly qualified is extremely important.
But before we get to the list today, please do not forget to give the video a like if you enjoy it. It really helps the video out. And please subscribe to the channel if you want to stay up to date on some of the latest Harley content. But let's take a look at our first cam on the list today. This is from Zippers. And if you guys watched the video on the 107 Milwaukee 8, you may remember the Zippers 468. The Zippers RS468 is an excellent all-around cam, great power off the line, revs out pretty good on the high end, and plus one of the best part about these cams for you touring guys, this thing works really well even if you have your stock head pipe with the cat in it and just a set of high flow mufflers. So let's see what that RS468 can do in a 114 engine.
Now here we have the power numbers on the Zippers RS468. We took a look at this cam in the 107, had a nice graph, good pull on it, but the difference is on this 114, this thing's making 110 horsepower at the peak and a max torque of 124.47. Our power starts to come on right here, roughly about 2100 RPM. And as you're rolling on the throttle, the horsepower is climbing, as well as your torque. Got a nice little smooth torque curve here, both on torque and horsepower. And we get our max torque of 124.47 up here at roughly about 3500 RPM. So you got to think, when you're running down the road, that's about right in the range that you're going to be riding. Then if you're really revving this thing out pretty hard, we get up here to about 4,500 RPM. We're just cracking about 100 horsepower. But up here, it starts to run out to its max of 110 horsepower. Looks like roughly just shy of about 6,000 RPM. So max horsepower is pretty way up there.
So guys, Zippers RS468, what do you think? Yay? Nay? I think it's a good all-around cam. I think it produces pretty dang good power in a 114. Now the Zippers RS468, this is going to give you a 24 horsepower gain over stock and a 17 foot-pound of torque gain over stock. And these cams will generally run you about $250. But just bear in mind that's for the cam alone, and that doesn't include the cost of installing it if you're not doing it yourself and some of the other assorted gaskets and goodies depending on how you go about it. But the Zippers RS468, my opinion, great all-around cam. I like the power, I like the torque, but I want to know what you guys think in the comments. Now next up on my list is the S&S 475C. To me, this is a great Milwaukee 8114 cam. This is also S&S's 100 horsepower bolt-in cam, basically meaning you're going to get 100 horsepower out of this thing with an intake, exhaust system, and a good tune. S&S can pretty much almost guarantee that. Now this works with your stock valve train. Once again though, you will want adjustable push rods for installation to make it easier and also cheaper. And guys, the S&S 475, This thing's also quiet, easy on the valvetrain, and is 100% bolt-in. S&S never disappoints, and this cam is no exception. So let's go to the dyno chart and check it out.
All right, guys, the S&S 475C. This cam comes on a little bit earlier. Looks like just right at or just below 2,000 RPM. And the horsepower pulls pretty strong and steadily here. I mean, we've got a good curve on this thing. And right in about the 4,000 RPM range to roughly 4,500, we're getting up into the high 90s, up lower 100 horsepower here, which is great if you're in the throttle. Now, if you're in the throttle and you're running to go past somebody, this is a great area to be in, because look at the torque on this thing. I mean, we're not even to 4,000 RPM, and this thing's producing well over 120 foot-pounds of torque. But our horsepower climbs all the way up to its max of about 116 horsepower at roughly 6,000 RPM, so getting the max horsepower is pretty high on this cam, but we're getting our max torque at under 4 grand. So right here, about 3,900, it's bumping the max torque, but that max torque is 125 foot-pounds.
So guys, what'd you think of the S&S? S&S really doesn't disappoint when you look at the numbers. This cam's producing 30 horsepower over stock, and we're getting 18 foot-pounds of torque over stock. Now, me personally, I think the max power, the peak number on the power, comes out a little bit later for my taste at over 6,000 RPM. But with a Milwaukee 8 and a 4-valve head, you could definitely spin them up that hard if you want. But down in the middle where you ride, we're getting upper 90s, lower 100s as far as horsepower. But the max torque at 120 foot-pounds, that's coming on at roughly in the 3,500 range, which is really nice for passing power. Now, one brand that we don't particularly hear about all the time, it is Cyclorama. The Cyclorama cams are some excellent high horsepower, high torque producing cams. The Cyclorama CR480 is no exception. This is a high torque, high power, just an excellent overall street cam. The Cyclorama CR480 is a straight drop-in cam with your stock valve springs, and this cam's going to come on roughly about 2,000 RPMs. It's going to run out about 5,000 RPMs, but it's going to give you massive, massive low-end torque, which is definitely what you want if you have a heavier bike riding two up or you're riding with luggage. Now, this cam's a little different brand, but nonetheless, it's still quite the performer. Let's go check it out.
Now, guys, the Cyclorama CR480, this cam comes on way early. I mean, way earlier than we saw from Zippers and S&S. This cam's coming on roughly about 1,600 RPM. And when it comes to horsepower, this thing pulls right off the line. We have a nice, good, steady climb here. We get up, I mean, look at where the power's at, about 4,500. You're breaking 100 horsepower in the 4,500 RPM range. And then from there, it runs up to a pretty decent peak horsepower up here, roughly at about 5,700 RPM at 112 horsepower. Torque comes on strong right off the line, takes a little dip, but then it starts to pull. Now, even while it dips, the horsepower is still climbing. But up here on the torque, we got a nice, smooth torque curve. I mean, look at this, guys. We're hitting 120 foot-pounds, just a little over 3,000 RPM. And then here, our peak torque maxes out at 125 foot-pounds of torque. And this is only at 3,600 RPM. So guys, that is really early, but look at this. You still have this horsepower climbing at the same time. So even while your torque's on the way down, the horsepower's on the way up.
So guys, thoughts, opinions, Cyclorama CR480? Let me know in the comments. That is a nice street cam. That is just a perfect all-around cam. You got loads of torque down low. The horsepower runs out good. The torque runs out good. And the best part about it is it does it all somewhat early too, which is what I personally like on the street. Now the CR480 is giving us 26 additional horsepower over stock and about 18 foot-pounds of torque. Now you guys could probably see the pattern here so far. Horsepower varies a lot on these cams, but the torque's pretty much been between, you know, 18 to 20 foot-pounds of torque, so not a huge difference between the cams there. But the main difference so far is where that power is achieved at, where it comes on in the RPM range. Now, I mentioned I had a monster cam for you guys at the end of the video, and we're getting close, so stick with me, but I'll give you a hint. It is from Wood, surprise, surprise. Now, last week we saw the Wood WM8 222 in a 107. Now, I like this cam because it's a good all-around cam from Wood, not so much like the other two we're going to look at because they're more targeted for specific areas is all I'm going to say. But the WM8 222, you put this in a 114 and it really takes advantage of the added displacement in this thing. This thing comes on right off idle and pulls all the way out to 6,000 RPM. Let's take a look and see what this guy can do in a Milwaukee 8.
So believe it or not, the Wood WM8 222 is one of the milder wood cans we're going to look at today. But just as Wood says, just about right off idle, right here about 1,700 RPM, this thing comes on and immediately goes to work. Horsepower starts pulling hard. I mean, this thing is climbing all the way up here. We get up to about 4,000 RPM. The horsepower is a bit lower on this in the mid-range, but it does nothing but climb all the way. And I mean climb. This thing goes all the way up to almost 6,000 RPM, but we're getting 118 horsepower at 6,000 RPM. Now, torque comes on pretty steadily. We got over 100 foot-pounds just right off of idle before 2,500 RPM. And as you're running this thing out, it really takes a good hard pull here. We're almost at 120 foot-pounds of torque at only 3,500 RPM. But that's about the max torque on this. So once you hit 3,500 RPM, you kind of level off and then it starts to drop. But once again, at the same time, your horsepower is still climbing on this thing.
So not bad on the Wood 222 and the 114. I know it's kind of an older cam design, but that older cam design does produce 32 horsepower over stock, but it only gains about 12 foot-pounds of torque. But for $310, that's not too bad. I mean, just considering that's for the cam alone, it is a little bit expensive. But if you really want a good horsepower gain, the 222 is a good one to look at. Now, if you like the horsepower and torque numbers on the WM8 222 from Woods, but you're not so much interested in the big horsepower number, you'd really want a cam that produces maximum torque, well, you're really going to be looking at the WM8 22X. This is a very high torque cam, and what it lacks in the horsepower department, which don't get me wrong, the horsepower is still good, it really makes up for it in the torque.
The Wood WM8 22X comes on really early, right at about 1700 RPM, and for the horsepower, it goes right to work. I mean, this starts climbing. We get up here to about the 3500 range, between 3500 and 4000, really hitting about 90 horsepower. We're not even at 100 horsepower when at the 4000 RPM mark. But once again, this cam is really not all about horsepower. But the horsepower does start to climb, and we get up here to about 5600 RPM. We're putting out 111 horsepower. So very respectable for a cam that's not really designed to be all-out horsepower producer. Now, torque on the other hand is another story. This comes on at 1700 RPM, takes a little bit of a dip, and as you're rolling on the throttle, this torque is climbing, and it's climbing hard. And it reaches its max just above 3600 RPM as far as torque. But at about 3600 RPM, you're getting 126 foot-pounds of torque. That is the most torque of all the cams that we've looked at so far today. That's what this cam's all about, is the maximum torque.
126 foot-pounds of torque at just over 3,500 RPM. That's a lot. That is impressive from just a bolt-in camshaft. Now, the 22X from Wood, this is going to give you 19 foot-pounds of torque over stock, and it's going to give you about 25 horsepower over stock. Now, while that doesn't sound like a lot in comparison to the other cams, it's that lower RPM at which it hits that. 126 at just over 3,500. That's going to be a blast to ride, guys. Now for the monster bolt-in cam. The Wood WM8 22XE. And if you're wondering what the XE stands for, that stands for extreme. This cam is absolutely insane. And Wood says that this thing gains about 8 to 10 horsepower over its 22X cam, if you can believe that. If you're looking for absolute max horsepower, max torque, the most you can get with your stock valve springs and really push the limits of your M8 with just a bolt-in cam, this is the cam to do it. Let's go check it out.
The WM8 22XE, immediately, just looking at this chart, you could tell this cam means business. This thing comes on a little later, just at about just under 2100 RPM for the horsepower, and I mean, it is game on as soon as you let the clutch out. This thing starts climbing and pulling. Now, between 3500 and 4000 RPM, we're not even really hitting 100 horsepower. I mean, we're in the low 90s, and then we come through the mids, up till we hit our 100 horsepower at about 4000 RPMs. But this thing doesn't stop. I mean, it runs all the way up to roughly, what are we looking at here, about
about 5,400 RPM. And at 5,400 RPM, we're getting 120 horsepower. So it does have a little bit higher RPM for its max, but at 5,400, that's a lot of power. That's coming on a lot lower than what we saw with our other cams. Now, torque, holy crap, look at the torque. This, under 2,000 RPMs, it's coming on. I mean, this thing just climbs. We're not even at 2,500 RPM, and this cam is putting down 120 foot-pounds of torque. We're about 125 at 2,500 RPM. And by the time you hit 3,000 RPM, you're over 130 foot-pounds of torque. This thing is putting down its maximum torque of 132 foot-pounds at only 3,500 RPM. I mean, you're hitting it right here, but this is where it peaks. And this torque, I mean, it flattens out at right about 100, over 130 foot-pounds of torque all the way till you come up to about 4,000 RPM. And only after 4,000 RPM does your torque start to drop off. But after 4,000 RPM, you're still feeling all that torque, and the horsepower is still climbing.
Whew, yeah, guys, I gotta admit, that is an extreme cam. Can you believe that's just a straight bolt-in cam? The only thing that is required with it is the adjustable push rods. But guys, this cam is bolt-in 34 horsepower over stock and an additional 25 foot-pounds of torque. And it's not like it puts this power way up in the RPM range. This power is still pretty much in the mid-range. It's not its peak, but its power output in the mid-range is higher than any other cam we looked at today. This is one extreme cam. Wood was not messing around when they made this cam. Whew. So guys, what was your favorite cam today? Which one did you like the best? My personal thoughts are the Zippers cam, the S&S, or the Cyclorama. These would be your better all-around cams. Now, when it comes to all-out targeting an area as far as power, I would have to go with the Wood 22X for torque and the Wood 22XE just for all-out horsepower and torque. But I think for somebody that's just an everyday rider like myself, I would probably go with either the Zippers, the Cyclorama, or the S&S. That'd be a pretty hard choice for me right there. So the added displacement, even though it's only 7 cubic inches over the 107 and that 114, it really does take big advantage of bolt-in cams. Now, the horsepower is pretty decent over it, but where we really see the increase with the 114 is when it comes to the torque, and that's just with the bigger displacement. But in the end, guys, I think the S&S and the Redshift were some of the better all-around cams as far as horsepower and torque-producing numbers are. Now, the Cyclorama, I really like that one for its low-end torque and mid-range power. Now, as always, when you're cam shopping, guys, don't get hung up on these peak torque and horsepower numbers. Yes, they're important, but the most important thing to look at is really look at these dyno graphs and look at where this power comes on. Whether you're targeting low, mid, or upper RPM range, you want to compare that to where you're riding. Because if you just go by peak horsepower and torque numbers and you pick a cam solely based on that, you might be very, very disappointed with the outcome when you put that cam in your bike, because it's not going to match up with any bit of your riding style. Anyhow, guys, that's all I've got for you this week. Please don't forget to hit that like button if you enjoyed the video. Help it out, get it shared with others. When this video gets released, it is going to be Memorial Weekend. So guys, I hope you get out, get on some good rides, have a good time, enjoy yourselves. Please, please be safe out there. There's going to be a lot of people on the road. They're all going out to having a good time, and the last thing they're thinking about is watching for us out there on motorcycles. So till next week, guys, please be safe, dodge the cars, and I'll catch you guys in next week's video. Thanks for watching.